So expansion of gases. Now I will discuss the different concepts in expansion of gases. Okay, first, suppose I have enclosed the gas in a cylindrical vessel by means of a frictionless piston. Suppose initially the temperature of the gas is say T1. Now by supplying the heat energy to the gas, when the temperature of the gas is increased, because the kinetic energy of average kinetic energy of each molecular atom is directly proportional to a Kelvin scale of temperature. That means when kinetic energy of the particle increases, temperature also increases. That's why when we supply the heat energy, kinetic energy of the particle increases, so the temperature also increases. So by supplying the heat energy, here suppose I increase the temperature. When temperature increases, means kinetic energy of each and every particle increases, so the pressure increases. Suppose I want to keep the pressure constant. Even temperature of the gas increases from T1 to T2. Even here you see, initially the pressure of the gas is say T1. Initially the pressure of the gas is T1. It is the gas. Okay. At a temperature 0 degrees centigrade, suppose the pressure of the gas is P0 and volume is say V0. Here at a temperature 0 degrees centigrade, the gas is enclosed in the cylindrical vessel by means of a piston. Now, the pressure of the gas enclosed in the vessel is P0 and volume P0. Now, the temperature is increased to 3 degrees centigrade. Why I have considered the temperature at the X1? Temperature of the gas at 0 degrees centigrade means expansion of the gas is very large, even there is a small rise of temperature. That's why I have considered the volume of the gas and pressure of the gas even at 0 degrees centigrade also. Okay, now, when the temperature of the gas is increased to 3 degrees centigrade, temperature of the gas increases to T degree centigrade means kinetic energy of particle increases. Average kinetic energy is directly proportional to temperature. No? That's why kinetic energy increases. When kinetic energy increases, the number of collisions made by each and every particle with the walls of the container increases. That's why pressure increases. Okay, so pressure increases. But I want to keep the pressure constant. So by keeping the pressure, in order to keep the pressure constant, whenever temperature increases, pressure increases. But in order to keep the pressure constant, we have to move the piston outwards. So when you move the piston outwards, so that the pressure of the gas reaches the original initial pressure. But volume increases now. That's why at a temperature T2, at a temperature 3 degrees centigrade, say volume is Vt. That means the volume of the gas can be increased by keeping the pressure constant. By keeping the pressure constant, the volume of the gas increases by rise of temperature. Or by keeping the volume constant also, we can increase the pressure of the gas. That's why when temperature of the gas increases, by keeping pressure constant, we can increase the volume. By keeping the volume constant, we can increase the pressure. That's why in case of gases, there are two types of expansions are there. Expansion of the pressure, expansion of the volume. Okay. So here, in order to study the, you see here, volume expansion of the gas, pressure expansion of the gas. Okay. Increase in volume of the gas when temperature is increased from 0 to 3 degrees centigrade at constant pressure P0. The increase in volume of the gas, Vt minus P0, is directly proportional to rise of temperature T minus 0 and also proportional to the initial volume at 0 degrees centigrade. When you club these two, Vt minus P0 is equal to some proportional, Vt minus P0 is proportional to V0 into T minus 0, means T, or Vt minus V0 is equal to some proportionality constant alpha into V0 into T. Here alpha means, in case of gases, alpha means volume coefficient of the gas. So therefore, alpha is equal to Vt minus V0 by V0 into T. This proportionality constant alpha is called volume coefficient of gas. Volume coefficient of gas, alpha. Okay, so from this formula, this is the formula for volume coefficient of the gas. So volume coefficient of the gas is the increase in volume per unit initial volume. Because whenever the initial volume is V0, it is the increase in volume. And increase in volume per unit initial volume means Vt minus V0 by V0. It is the fraction of increase in volume of the gas at constant pressure. Here by temperature, that means rise of temperature. By rise of temperature means 1 degree centigrade. So a fractional increase in volume of the gas per 1 degree centigrade rise of temperature is called the volume coefficient of the gas. the fraction of increase in volume of the gas at constant pressure for 1 degree centigrade rise of temperature. Okay, for T degree centigrade rise of temperature, it is the fraction of increase in volume. For 1 degree centigrade rise of temperature, what is the fraction of increase in volume? It is Vt minus V0 by V0 into T. So, the fraction of increase in volume of the gas for 1 degree centigrade rise of temperature at constant pressure is called volume coefficient of the gas. Volume coefficient of the gas we can write at constant pressure also. Volume coefficient of the gas at constant pressure we can write at constant pressure. At constant pressure. Alpha. This is represented with alpha. Okay. Here when alpha value is calculated experimentally, they got alpha is equal to 1 by 273.15, so approximately 1 by 273 per degree centigrade or per degree Kelvin. Okay, this is the alpha value. Okay, next, similarly, by keeping the volume constant, we can increase the pressure. In such case, you will get the pressure coefficient of the gas at constant volume. So, pressure coefficient of gas at constant volume. At constant volume. That is represented with beta. Pressure coefficient of the gas at constant volume. So here at 0 degree centigrade, the pressure of the gas is P0 and volume is V0. By keeping the volume constant means you fix the piston without moving. You can fix and fix piston kadalakanda fixes and it is the piston. The piston kadalakanda fixes is temperature raise cheyandi. Appudu piston kadalagaadu volume constant ga. That's why whenever the temperature of the gas is increased to T degrees centigrade by keeping the volume constant, it means same volume, then the pressure of the gas increased to say Pt. Then the increase in pressure of the gas Pt minus P0 at constant volume, at constant volume, okay, increase in pressure Pt minus P0 is directly proportional to the initial pressure and also proportional to the rise of temperature T minus 0 means T. Okay. Or Pt minus P0, opposite is T. Or Pt minus P0 is directly proportional to P0 into T. Or Pt minus P0 is equal to some proportionality constant beta into P0 into T. Here the proportionality constant beta is called pressure coefficient of the gas at constant volume. So from that beta is equal to Pt minus P0 by V0 into T. Okay, here how we can define this pressure coefficient of the gas at constant volume. So at constant volume, the fraction of increase in pressure of the gas per 1 degree centigrade rise of temperature is called pressure coefficient of the gas at constant volume. So at constant volume, the increase in pressure of the gas per unit initial pressure, that is called fractional increase in pressure of the gas. A degree centigrade rise of temperature, that is called the pressure coefficient of the gas at constant volume. So at constant volume, the fractional increase in volume of the increase in pressure of the gas or 1 degree centigrade rise of temperature is called the pressure coefficient of the gas at constant volume. From this we can write Pt minus P0 is equal to this one, like this. Then you bring here P0 to right side and you take P0 common, then Pt is equal to, you will have P0 you bring to right side. And then you take P0 common. Pt is equal to P0 into 1 plus beta T. Similarly, Pt is equal to V0 into 1 plus alpha T. Here beta value is also calculated, measured as 1 by 273 per degree centigrade. So from this experimental results, it is clear that alpha is equal to beta. Numerically, alpha is equal to beta. So in case of any gas, the pressure coefficient of the gas at constant volume and volume coefficient of the gas at constant pressure both are equal. So alpha is equal to beta. Okay, next. So this alpha beta values are useful to find the expansion of the gases. Okay, now we have to discuss the gas laws. Up to this only you may not know, but remaining all concepts, Charles' law, Boyle's law, everything you know. So now gas loss, very, very important. Most of the problems may ask from this gas loss only. Gas loss. So gas loss means these are the equations gives the relation among the various physical quantities related to any gas. Every gas can be described in terms of pressure, volume, temperature. Mainly. Every gas can be described. Every gas can be described with the help of their properties like pressure, volume, and temperature. These are called thermodynamic coordinates. Of course, entropy, enthalpy, etc. also there. But mainly, every gas can be described in terms of mainly pressure, volume, and temperature. So that's why these are called thermodynamic coordinates. Okay. Now, first one, Boyle's law. First one, Boyle's law. At constant temperature, temperature capital T, the pressure of the given mass of gas is inversely proportional to its volume. At constant temperature, the pressure of the given mass of gas is inversely proportional to its volume. R T D is equal to some constant. dV is equal to some constant. And a constant temperature, the pressure of the given mass of gas is inversely proportional to its volume. Or PV is equal to, we can write P is equal to some constant by volume, or PV is equal to constant. So we can write PV is equal to constant. So at constant temperature, at constant temperature T, suppose the pressure of the gas is P1 and volume is say V1. When pressure is changed to P2, volume becomes say V2. Then P1, V1 is equal to P2, V2, we can write. As at constant temperature, pressure is inversely proportional to volume, then we can write PV graph like this. So in this Boyle's law, first point, PV graph. Suppose if you draw the graph between P and V, in case of any two physical quantities in which the relation between them is one is inversely proportional to other, if you draw the graph between them, definitely you will get a rectangular hyperbola. Rectangular hyperbola means at certain positions, the graph is parallel to volume axis, parallel to this pressure axis also. Okay, this is the rectangular hyperbola. Rectangular hyperbola. Okay. Now it is the pressure volume graph. Okay, next B. Suppose for the given mass of gas at constant temperature, the temperature is constant. Here, temperature is constant. At constant temperature, suppose if you draw the graph between PV and the product of pressure and volume, P R V, then what is the type of the graph you will get? A constant temperature, P V is called constant together, and a P value increases, V decreases, and P decreases, V increases. But product remains constant. That's why at a constant temperature, when you draw the graph between P V and P, you will get a straight line. If you draw P V and V, you will get a straight line because even pressure changes or volume changes, the product remains constant at constant temperature. So you will get the graph like this. Suppose at same temperature, at same temperature, the two different masses of the gas, if I draw the this PV graph for different gases. Okay, for the same gas first. In the ideal gas equation, you can talk about the point of discuss the same gas at different temperatures. By keeping the different temperatures constant, the PV graphs are drawn. Suppose one graph is drawn by keeping the temperature T1 constant. By keeping the temperature of the gas T1 constant, when PV graph is drawn, the graph is obtained like this. By keeping the temperature of the gas at T2 constant, again the same type of graph is drawn. By keeping the temperature T2 constant, then I got the graphs like this. Now, what is the relation between T1 and T2? I think you can say in chemistry it has come. I think you have studied in chemistry. For the same gas, yes, at two different temperatures keeping constant, when I drawn the PV graphs, I got like this. From these graphs, what is the relation between T1 and T2? What is the relation between T1 and T2? T2 greater than Okay. What is the area under this graph? Tell me. What is the area under the pressure walling graph? Area under pressure walling graph is P into V. P into V means work done. P into V means work done. Okay. We will discuss in next thermodynamic chapter. Now, you see here. Suppose you draw a horizontal line. You draw a horizontal line exactly at this point. At this point, in two cases, pressures are same. At this case, temperature volume is this one. At this case, volume is here. At this point, volume is say V1. At this point, as the temperature is T2, volume is say V2. At constant pressure, because in two cases, here and here, pressure is kept constant. At constant temperature, so V2 is greater than V1, no? At constant temperature, as we know, at constant pressure, volume is directly proportional to Kelvin scale of temperature. Now, according to Charles' law, actually, I would say this concept there. Okay, after. I will say this concept there only after completion of the Charles' law. That's not only a little bit later. I will explain. Okay, next. Okay, next. Here one application, one more application. Suppose there is a lake. It is the bed of the lake. It is the bed of the lake. And here water is there. Water is there. Here one bubble is there at the bottom of the. One bubble is there at the bottom of the lake. One air bubble is there at the bottom of the lake whose radius is small r1. Whose radius is small r1. Okay. Here, as the bind force acts on the bubble, the bind force acts on the bubble is greater than the weight of the air inside the bubble. That's why the bubble goes to the top. When the bubble goes to the top here, as the pressure acts on the bubble gradually decreases, the volume increases whenever temperature is constant. Suppose T is constant, say. Then whenever the bubble reaches the point here, then the size of the bubble becomes like this, so that the radius becomes r2. Radius becomes r2. Now, suppose at this position, the pressure acts on the bubble is say p1. At this position, pressure is say p2, and radius r1, r2. When you know the radii, then volumes are known. So, as that here, the air inside the bubble obeys the Boyle's law, because temperature is constant at the top and bottom of the water lake. The temperature is constant. That's why the bubble obeys the Boyle's law. According to Boyle's law, suppose the pressure of the gas at the pressure of the air inside the bubble at the bottom is say P1, at the top it is P2. Then according to Boyle's law, we can write P1V1 is equal to P2V2. No? Now tell me, what is the pressure at the bottom? Suppose the depth of the lake is say H. Then what is the pressure of the pressure acts on the bubble at the bottom? When it is at the bottom, what is the pressure at the bottom? Atmosphere pressure acts on the surface, so that acts at this point. Pressure due to this liquid column also, pressure acts at this point. So total pressure at that point is equal to P0 plus H rho z. Rho is the density of the water. Okay, volume. Volume is here 4/3 pi r cube, we can write now. So volume of the bubble is 4/3 pi r1 cube is equal to P2. P2 is the pressure acts on the bubble when it reaches the top or surface of the liquid or surface of the water in a lake. So whenever it reaches the surface of the lake, then almost all the pressure acts on the bubble is equal to only atmosphere pressure only. The pressure, extra pressure due to surface tension, they are ignored, because the surface tension is not given. That's why they can be ignored. So only atmosphere pressure acts into volume 4/3 pi r2 cube. So here 4/3 pi cancel. Then P0 plus H rho z into r1 cube is equal to p0 into r2 cube. This is the relation. So if you know the r1 value, by using this formula we can find the r2 value. If you are given r1 and r2, sometimes you will be given volume of the bubble is here v1, here volume of the bubble is v2. Directly we can write v1 v2 like that, or volume of the bubble becomes double when it reaches the top. That means V2 is equal to 2V1 we have to write. Like that we can write. Okay. How we can substitute the pressures? That is important here. Here, atmospheric pressure, that is 76 cm of Hg. Atmospheric pressure is 76 cm of Hg. But here, this is the water column, not mercury column. It is the water column. How we can write in terms of water column? Here, we have to remember one thing. One atmosphere, one atmospheric pressure is equal to 76 cm of Hg. That is equal to 10 meter of water. 10 meter of water. And 10 meter height of water column la panjese pressure, 76 centimeter height of mercury column la panjese pressure, rendu same. Kabatti atmosphere pressure, instead of one atmosphere pressure, we can substitute 10 meter directly. Okay. Now, the same equation can be written as simply capital H plus small h. Suppose if we express this P naught in terms of Newton per meter square, then we have to use this formula. Okay, atmosphere pressure equal to 76 cm of Hg means how many Newton per meter square? How many Newton per meter square? 1.01 into 10 to the power 5 Newton per meter square. No? If we express this atmosphere pressure in terms of Newton per meter square, then we can use this formula H rho z. 1.01 into 10 to the power 5 plus height of the mercury water column plus into density of the water in SI system, G10. P naught means 1.01 into 10 to the power 5. In such a way, we can write. But calculation becomes difficult there because we have to multiply all this. Suppose if you want to write only in terms of heights, then atmosphere pressure is capital H, height of the water column, height of the depth of the lake is equal to small h into R1. R1 cube is equal to P naught means H into R2 cube. Here, what is the H value? No doubt, we know the depth of the lake. That will be given in terms of meters. Here, depth of the lake means it is the water depth. When you are given water depth, when you substitute here water depth, 10 meter, 20 meter, like that, we must substitute the atmosphere pressure in terms of water columns only. One atmosphere pressure or 76 cm of H is equal to 10 meter of water, no? That's why here we have substitute 10 meter. 10 meter plus 10 meter is the height of the water column. It is the depth of the water column. So we can substitute directly in meters here and here. No problem. Then what is R2 or what is R1? What is the percentage increase in radius of the, sometimes they may ask, what is the percentage increase in radius of the bubble when it travels from bottom to the top? Bottom to top, percentage increase in radius is 100. And R2 minus R1 by R1 into 100. That is the percentage change in the radius. When it travel from top, bottom to top. Means R2 by R1 vastundi kada. Ikkada split cheyandi. R2 by R1 minus 1 into 100. R2 by R1 value substitute cheyandi, simplify cheyandi. You will get percentage change in the radius. Sometimes they may ask percentage change in the volume. So here, P1 means we can substitute P0 plus H rho z, or we can write directly like this. This is one equation. Okay, or we can write capital H plus small h into atmosphere pressure at the bottom means P0 plus H rho z. This can be written as capital H plus small h into volume V1 is equal to, when it reaches the top, only atmosphere pressure acts, into volume V2. So what is the percentage change in volume, they may ask. Percentage change in volume is V2 minus V1 by V1 into 100. That is equal to how much? That is equal to V2 by V1 minus 1 into 100. That is equal to V2 by V1 means capital H plus small h by capital H. V2 by V1 is equal to capital H plus small h by capital H minus 1 into 100. That is equal to, when you split them, small h by capital H into 100. That is the percentage change in volume. This is the percentage change in volume. So by using this formula, we can find the percentage change in volume. Just if you know atmosphere pressure in terms of water column and depth of the water lake, then we can find percentage increase in volume of the bubble when it reaches the top from the bottom. Okay, this is one example application. Number of times they asked in MCET also. ఈ ప్రాబ్లం ఈ కాన్సెప్ట్ మీద ఎంసెట్ లో కూడా ప్రాబ్లమ్స్ అడిగారండి మోస్ట్ ఇంపార్టెంట్ ఇన్ ఆర్డర్ టు వెరిఫై ద బాయిల్స్ లా ఎక్స్పెరిమెంటల్లీ వి ఆర్ హావింగ్ బాయిల్స్ ఆపరేటర్స్ ఇన్ కేస్ ఆఫ్ బాయిల్స్ ఆపరేటర్ వి యూస్ ద సేమ్ ఫార్ములా హియర్ ఓన్లీ P1 V1 = P2 V2 కాన్సెప్ట్ ఓన్లీ అండ్ Q2 ఇస్ ఆల్సో దేర్ నెక్స్ట్ Q2 of course it is C, no? It is C. Next, B. another application of the Boyle's law. In order to verify the Boyle's law, we use to verify Boyle's law. We use Boyle's operators, or filchow. Okay, now filchow we have to discuss, because by means of Boyle's operators, what is the how we can verify the Boyle's law means just by using the same formula. Here P1 V1 is equal to P2 V2. P1 is the pressure, V is the volume. Volume means in Boyle's operators, I think you have seen in 10th class in schools. Cylindrical tube is there. The volume of the gas is proportional to length. That's why P1 L1 is equal to P2 L2. We can write. Okay, next fill tube. You take the fill tube means that is the capillary tube. You take the fill tube. Okay, that means that the fill tube is constructed with capillary tube. You take the capillary tube whose one end is closed. Okay, end close the same. End open chain. Approximately the length of the quill tube is about 50 centimeter and a half meter. So approximately 50 centimeter length of a quill tube is going whose one end you close. You take the capillary tube having length about 50 centimeter and you close one end and you fix the capillary tube to the scale of length 50 centimeter. It is 50 centimeter na scale and going. Okay, the quill tube in the fixation. Quill tube and the capillary tube. You fix the capillary tube to the scale parallel to its length so that whose one end is closed, another end is open. This end open cheyabadundani. Okay, this quill tube. Here, just on the scale, you fix this quill tube and this capillary tube by means of clamps or by means of rubber bands. Rubber bands are thinni, itla fix chesayi. Itla fix chesayi. Then this arrangement is called the quill tube. Ikkada scale kuda undi kada, aa scale kuda mark cheyandi. Because on the scale only it is fixed. You are having factor also in intermediate. So on the scale only it is fixed. Here, this arrangement is called fill tube. Fill tube can be held by means of the clamp attached to the vertical stand or radar stand. A stand is there. And the clamp of the fill tube, we can use any orientation to the orientation of the turnator. We can use horizontal to the horizontal. We can use open end of the fill tube, vertical to upward direction to the upward direction. ఆ తర్వాత దీంట్లో ఏం చేస్తారంటే ఫిల్చూబ్ అంటే ఇది క్యాపిటల్ ట్యూబ్ అని చెప్పారు కదా, దీంట్లో ఫైన్ బోర్ ఉంటుంది, 1 mm డయామీటర్ లేదా 1.5 mm డయామీటర్ ఒక బోర్ ఉంటుంది. దాంట్లో ఏం చేస్తారంటే ఆల్రెడీ వెన్ ఎవర్ దిస్ క్యాపిటల్ ట్యూబ్ ఇస్ ఓపెన్ టు అట్మాస్ఫియర్ సమ్ ఎయిర్ ఎంటరింగ్ టు ద ఫిల్చూబ్ దెన్ ఆఫ్టర్ ఎంటరింగ్ టు వెన్ ఎవర్ ఇట్ ఇస్ ఓపెన్ టు అట్మాస్ఫియర్ సమ్ ఎయిర్ ఇస్ ఎంటర్డ్ దెన్ యు ఇంట్రోడ్యూస్ ద మెర్క్యూరీ పిలెట్ అంటే స్మాల్ మెర్క్యూరీని ఇంకొక ఇన్సర్ట్ చేయండి. ఆ ఇన్సర్ట్ చేసినప్పుడు ఆ మెర్క్యూరీ కిందకి డ్రాప్ అయ్యి సపోజ్ మెర్క్యూరీ ఇక్కడ దాకా వచ్చి ఆగిపోయింది అనుకుందాం. దిస్ ఇస్ కాల్డ్ మెర్క్యూరీ థ్రెడ్ ఆర్ మెర్క్యూరీ ప్లేట్. ఇట్ ఈస్ కాల్డ్ మెర్క్యూరీ థ్రెడ్ ఆర్ మెర్క్యూరీ ప్లేట్ అంటే ఈ మెర్క్యూరీ కాలం మనకి కొంత లెంత్ గల మెర్క్యూరీ కాలం ఎట్లా కనిపిస్తుంది అంటే ఒక థ్రెడ్ లాగా కనిపిస్తుంది. దాని మెర్క్యూరీ థ్రెడ్ అనొచ్చు లేదా మెర్క్యూరీ ప్లేట్ అని కూడా అనొచ్చు. మెర్క్యూరీ ప్లేట్ ఆర్ మెర్క్యూరీ థ్రెడ్ ఆర్ థ్రెడ్. Okay, now here by means of mercury, some air is enclosed in the quill tube. Enclosed in the quill tube ki mercury ki madhyalo air unnatle kada, so some air is enclosed in the quill tube by means of this mercury pellet. Deentlo kontha air enclosed cheyabadindi, air. Of course idu kuda air, but it is always at atmosphere pressure. Kani deentlo unna air mercury pellet try to comes down. That's why mercury pellet some exert some pressure on this air column. That's why the pressure of this air column is not equal to atmosphere pressure, more than atmosphere pressure. So it is air is here. Okay, now is this air obeys the Boyle's law or not? We have to check. Deentlo enclosed cheyabadina air Boyle's law obey chestunda ledha anedi manam check cheyali. That is our air. Okay, Okay. So first of all, will tube is kept vertical in this case. In this first case, will tube is kept vertical. Will tube is vertical with open end upwards. Open end upwards. అంటే ఇక్కడ ఫిల్ ట్యూబ్ ని వెర్టికల్ గా ఉంచి ఓపెన్ అండ్ అప్వర్డ్ డైరెక్షన్ ఉండేట్టుగా అరేంజ్ చేసాం. ఎట్ ద టైం వాట్ ఇస్ ద ప్రెజర్, వాట్ అబౌట్ ద ప్రెజర్ ఆఫ్ ది ఎయిర్ అండ్ వాట్ అబౌట్ ద లెంత్, వాట్ ఇస్ ద ప్రెజర్ అండ్ వాట్ ఇస్ ద లెంత్ ఆఫ్ ది ఎయిర్ కాలమ్. ఇక్కడ ఈ కేసు లో లెంత్ ఆఫ్ ది ఎయిర్ కాలమ్ అంటే ఇక్కడ నుంచి ఇక్కడ వరకు సపోజ్ L1 అనుకుందాం. ఎందుకంటే క్లోజ్ ఎండ్ దగ్గర నుంచి మెర్క్యూరీ ప్లేట్ యొక్క బాటమ్ వరకు ఉన్న లెంత్ లెంత్ ఆఫ్ ది ఎయిర్ కాలమ్ అవుతుంది. ఇక్కడ లెంత్ ఆఫ్ ది ఎయిర్ కాలమ్ అది L1 అనుకుందాం. అంటే ఇక్కడ రీడింగ్ నోట్ చేస్తే దట్ ఇస్ L1. లెంత్ ఆఫ్ ది ఎయిర్ కాలమ్ నోట్ చేయండి. ఓకే, నెక్స్ట్. సో అట్ ఫస్ట్ వెన్ ఫిల్ ట్యూబ్ ఇస్ కెప్ట్ వెర్టికల్ లైక్ దిస్, లెంత్ ఆఫ్ ది ఎయిర్ కాలమ్ ఇస్ L1 అండ్ ప్రెజర్ ఆఫ్ ది ఎయిర్ ఇన్సైడ్ ద ఫిల్ ట్యూబ్ ఇస్ సే P1. ఓకే, ఇన్ దిస్ కేస్. నెక్స్ట్, సో ప్రెజర్ ఇస్ P1 అండ్ లెంత్ ఆఫ్ ది ఎయిర్ కాలమ్ ఇస్, వాల్యూమ్ ఆఫ్ ది ఎయిర్ కాలమ్ ఇస్ ఈక్వల్ టు area of cross section of the tube. Area of cross section ikkada volume of the air column kaadu, volume of the air column is equal to area of cross section. Area of cross section to length of the air column is the volume ega. Area of cross section idi tube mottam constant e kabatti therefore volume is directly proportional to length. Length l kabatti volume place lo manam length raaskovachu. Volume is directly proportional to length l1 in this case. Okay, next, when fill tube is kept ఇంక్లినేషన్, ఫిల్ ట్యూబ్ ని కొంత ఇంక్లినేషన్ తో ఇట్లా ఉంచాం. ఈ మొత్తం డ్రా చేయట్లేదండి, డైరెక్ట్ గా ఫిల్ ట్యూబ్ ఒకటే నోట్ చేస్తున్నాం. ట్యూబ్ క్యాపిల్లరీ ట్యూబ్ ఒకటే. హియర్ ఆల్సో క్యాపిల్లరీ ఫినామినా డ్యూ టు సర్ఫేస్ టెన్షన్ ఇస్ ఇగ్నోర్డ్, అంటే సర్ఫేస్ టెన్షన్ మనకి ఇవ్వలేదు కాబట్టి దాన్ని ఇగ్నోర్ చేస్తున్నాం. సో ఇప్పుడు ఈ ఫిల్ ట్యూబ్ ని ఇక్కడ టర్న్ చేసాం, ఇట్ ఏ లిటిల్ బిట్ ఇట్ ఇస్ టర్న్డ్ లైక్ దిస్ సో దట్ ఇట్ మేక్స్ ఎన్ యాంగిల్ తీటా విత్ వెర్టికల్, వెర్టికల్ తో తీటా యాంగిల్ చేసేట్టుగా టర్న్ చేసాం. టర్న్ చేసినప్పుడు సపోజ్ మెర్క్యూరీ ప్లేట్ ఇక్కడికి వచ్చింది అనుకుందాం. మెర్క్యూరీ ప్లేట్ యొక్క లెంత్ మారదండి. ఇక్కడ మెర్క్యూరీ ప్లేట్ యొక్క హైట్ సపోజ్ వెనవర్ ద ట్యూబ్ ఇస్ వెర్టికల్, ద హైట్ ఆఫ్ ది మెర్క్యూరీ కాలమ్ ఇస్ ఏ హెచ్, ఆర్ లెంత్ ఆఫ్ ది మెర్క్యూరీ ప్లేట్ ఇస్ ఏ హెచ్. ఈ లెంత్ హెచ్ ఇదే మారదు, దిస్ ఇస్ ఈక్వల్ టు హెచ్ ఉంది. దిస్ ఇస్ ద ఎయిర్ కాలమ్. సో లెంత్ ఆఫ్ ది ఎయిర్ కాలమ్ ఇక్కడ నుంచి ఇక్కడికి లెంత్ ఆఫ్ ది ఎయిర్ కాలమ్ సపోజ్ L2 అనుకోండి. సో ఇన్ దిస్ కేస్ వాట్ ఇస్ ద ప్రెజర్, హియర్ వాట్ ఇస్ ద ప్రెజర్. సో here the pressure of the air column is say P2, length of the air column is say L2. Now temperature of the air remains constant according to Boyle's law. Temperature constant అయినప్పుడు as we know at constant temperature P1 V1 is equal to P2 V2 కదండి. ఇక్కడ volume of the air column V2 అనుకుంటే V2 is directly proportional to L2. ఎందుకంటే volume of the air column is directly proportional to length కదా. P1 అంటే చెప్పండి, ఫస్ట్ కేస్ లో P1 అంటే ప్రెజర్ ఆఫ్ ది ఎయిర్ ఎన్క్లోజ్డ్ ఇన్ ద ట్యూబ్ ఇస్ ఈక్వల్ టు యాస్ ఇట్ ఇస్ ఓపెన్ టు అట్మాస్ఫియర్ అట్మాస్ఫియర్ ప్రెజర్ యాక్ట్స్ ఆన్ ది మెర్క్యూరీ ప్లేట్ విచ్ ఇన్ టర్న్ ఎగ్జర్ట్ ద సేమ్ ప్రెజర్ ఆన్ ది ఎయిర్ కాలమ్. అట్ ద సేమ్ టైం డ్యూ టు వెర్టికల్ హైట్ ఆఫ్ ది మెర్క్యూరీ ప్లేట్ ఆల్సో సమ్ ప్రెజర్ యాక్ట్స్, దట్స్ వై అట్మాస్ఫియర్ ప్రెజర్ క్యాపిటల్ హెచ్ ప్లస్ హైట్ ఆఫ్ ది మెర్క్యూరీ కాలమ్ ఇక్కడ స్మాల్ హెచ్ కాబట్టి స్మాల్ హెచ్ ఇంటూ వెర్టికల్ హైట్ ఆఫ్ ది మెర్క్యూరీ ప్లేట్ వల్లనే ప్రెజర్ తీసుకోవాలి. అయితే ఇక్కడ అట్మాస్ఫియర్ ప్రెజర్ మెర్క్యూరీ కాలమ్ అట్మాస్ఫియర్ ప్రెజర్ మెర్క్యూరీ కాలమ్స్ తో సబ్స్టిట్యూట్ చేసుకోవచ్చు. ఇది కూడా మెర్క్యూరీ కాబట్టి డైరెక్ట్ గా స్మాల్ హెచ్ అని రాస్తారు, రోజీ అని రాయలేక అవసరం లేదు. ఇంటూ వాల్యూమ్, వాల్యూమ్ అంటే ఏ కాలం యొక్క లెంత్ ప్రపోర్షనల్ గా ఉంటుంది కాబట్టి L1 ఇస్ ఈక్వల్ టు వెనెవర్ ద ఫిల్ ట్యూబ్ ఇస్ కట్ లైక్ దిస్ దెన్ యాజ్ ఇట్ ఇస్ ఓపెన్ టు అట్మాస్ఫియర్ అట్మాస్ఫియర్ యాక్ట్స్ ఆన్ ది మెర్క్యూరీ ప్లేట్ ఇన్ టర్న్ దట్ ఎగ్జర్ట్ అట్మాస్ఫియర్ ఆన్ ది దిస్ ఎయిర్ కాలమ్ ఆల్సో. సో అట్మాస్ఫియర్ హెచ్ ప్లస్ ఇక్కడ యాజ్ ద క్యాపిల్లరీ ట్యూబ్ ఇస్ ఇంక్లైన్డ్ ద మెర్క్యూరీ ప్లేట్ ఇస్ ఆల్సో ఇంక్లైన్డ్. So due to this mercury plate, what is the pressure of the air enclosed here means here whenever the mercury plate is like this, what is the vertical height of the mercury plate now? Vertical height of the mercury plate and this is the vertical height of the mercury plate H dash. If the angle theta is definitely E angle theta. Here two parallel lines are cut. Intersecting line cut theta. If H is equal to this is equal to H cos theta, then E length is equal. And if H is equal to H cos theta, then H cos theta. కాబట్టి ప్రెజర్ డ్యూ టు మెర్క్యూరీ ప్లేట్ ఆన్ ది ఎయిర్ కాలమ్ ఇస్ ఈక్వల్ టు వెర్టికల్ హైట్ ఆఫ్ ది మెర్క్యూరీ కాలమ్ ఇక్కడ తీసుకోవాలి, మెర్క్యూరీ ప్లేట్ ఇక్కడ తీసుకోవాలి అంటే హెచ్ డాష్. హెచ్ డాష్ అంటే హెచ్ కాస్ థీటా. ఓపెన్ అండ్ వెంట్రికల్ అప్వర్డ్ డైరెక్షన్ ఉంటే ఈ మెర్క్యూరీ కాలమ్ వల్ల వెంట్రికల్ హైట్ ఆఫ్ ది మెర్క్యూరీ పిల్లెట్ వల్ల కూడా ప్రెజర్ దీని మీద పనిచేస్తుంది. కాబట్టి యాడ్ చేయాలి అట్మాస్ఫియర్ ఇంటూ వి టూ అంటే యాడ్. సో బై యూజింగ్ దిస్ ఫార్ములా జస్ట్ ఈ థీటా తెలుస్తుంది మనకి, ఎల్ వన్ తెలుసు, ఓకే హెచ్ ప్లస్ హెచ్ ఇవన్నీ వాల్యూస్ తెలుసు. ఎల్ టూ క్యాల్కులేట్ ఎల్ టూ ఇక్కడ సబ్స్టిట్యూట్ చేయాలి, ఇక్కడ నోట్ చేస్తాం. ఇవన్నీ సబ్స్టిట్యూట్ చేస్తే ఈక్వేషన్ ఒబే చేస్తుంది. అవార్డ్ ఎట్లా ఇస్తా అంటే వెన్ అవర్ టిల్ టూ ఇస్ వెర్టికల్ లెంత్ ఆఫ్ ది ఎయిర్ కాలమ్ ఇస్ దిస్ వన్, వెన్ ఇట్ ఇస్ ఇంక్లైన్ వాట్ ఇస్ ద లెంత్ ఆఫ్ ది ఎయిర్ కాలమ్ యూ కెన్ ఫైండ్ బై యూజింగ్ దిస్ ఫార్ములా. ఓకే సపోజ్ వెన్ ద టిల్ టూ ఇస్ హారిజాంటల్, వెన్ టిల్ టూ ఇస్ హారిజాంటల్ లైక్ దిస్, when quill tube is horizontal the mercury plate is like this only, length of the mercury plate does not alter. Okay, now in this case what is the pressure of the air, in this case what is the pressure of the air enclosed in the quill tube, what is the pressure of the air enclosed in the quill tube in this case when quill tube is kept horizontal? Anybody else? When quill tube is kept horizontal what is the pressure of the air as it is open to atmosphere? Suppose if the quill tube is kept vertically downwards, open end is kept vertically downwards. Quill tube itla vertically downwards unchamandi. Length of the mercury plate maaradu, that is H only. Pressure becomes now say P3. Length of the air column is say L3. Okay. Now according to Boyle's law, whenever it is kept vertical, so that open end is vertically upwards, pressure is P1 and the length of the air column is L1. That's why from the formula P1 L1 is equal to P3 L3. P1 and enta atmosphere pressure plus pressure due to mercury column. So capital H plus small h into length of the air column L1 is equal to P3. And ఇక్కడ అట్మాస్ఫియర్ ప్రెజర్ పనిచేస్తాం కాబట్టి అట్మాస్ఫియర్ ప్రెజర్ దీని మీద పనిచేస్తుంది. అదే టైంలో ఈ మెర్క్యూరీ పిల్లెట్ వల్ల పనిచేసే ప్రెజర్ డౌన్వర్డ్స్ ఉంటుంది కాబట్టి ఆ అట్మాస్ఫియర్ ప్రెజర్ నుంచి మెర్క్యూరీ పిల్లెట్ వల్ల పనిచేసే ప్రెజర్ సబ్ట్రాక్ట్ చేయండి, అంటే క్యాపిటల్ హెచ్ మైనస్ స్మాల్ హెచ్ ఓకే ఇంటూ లెంత్ ఆఫ్ ది ఎయిర్ కాలమ్ ఎల్ త్రీ. ఇక్కడ ప్రెజర్ తక్కువ ఉంది కాబట్టి లెంత్ ఆఫ్ ది ఎయిర్ కాలమ్ విల్ బి మోర్ కంపేర్డ్ విత్ దిస్ వన్. సో బై ఇన్ దిస్ ఫార్ములా వీ కెన్ ఫైండ్ ద లెంత్ ఆఫ్ ది ఎయిర్ కాలమ్. ఓకే ఒకవేళ ఫిల్ ట్యూబ్ ఎక్క ఓపెన్ అండ్ ఇట్లా ఉంచాం అనుకోండి, ఫిల్ ట్యూబ్ ఎక్క ఓపెన్ అండ్ ఈ టైప్ లో ఉంది, ఈ టైప్ లో ఉన్నప్పుడు ఇక్కడ అట్మాస్ఫియర్ ప్రెజర్ మైనస్ వెర్టికల్ హైట్ ఆఫ్ ది మెర్క్యూరీ కాలమ్ ఇక్కడ నోట్ చేయాలి, వెర్టికల్ హైట్ ఆఫ్ ది మెర్క్యూరీ కాలమ్ అది. సో ఇన్ దిస్ వే విత్ ద హెల్ప్ ఆఫ్ ది క్విల్ ట్యూబ్ వి కెన్ వెరిఫై ద బాయిల్స్ లా ఆర్ వి కెన్ డు ద ప్రాబ్లమ్స్ బేస్డ్ ఆన్ దిస్ కాన్సెప్ట్. ఓకే చల ఎరేజ్ దిస్ పార్ట్ next what is the node point, what is the number of the node point, next node point what is the number of the node point, one only no. Already quill tube is over, application graphs are over, fourth was completed, fifth to be taught ఓకే థ్యాంక్స్. ఫిఫ్త్ నోట్ పాయింట్, సో ఇన్ ఫిఫ్త్ నోట్ పాయింట్ ఎయిర్ కంప్రెషర్ ఎయిర్ కంప్రెషర్ వర్క్స్ ఆన్ ది ప్రిన్సిపల్ ఆఫ్ బాయిల్స్ లా. So here there is a cylindrical vessel. There is a cylindrical vessel in the air compressor. At the bottom, it is open. At the bottom, it is having a side tube like this. Okay, here there is a lever. There is a lever. This side tube is closed with the piston, frictionless piston. Side tube is closed with piston. The by means of machinery, by means of power, we can make the piston to move to and fro like this. We can make the piston to move inwards or outwards. Here, it is having a side tube. It is having a side tube. A side tube is also fixed, and that side tube is closed with valve. It is having a side tube, which is closed with the valve. So air can come out through this. When you open the valve, air comes out through this side tube. In that way, the mechanism is there. When you push the piston inwards, immediately the lever will be closed so that no air enter into this vessel. No air enter into this vessel. Suppose initially, here the volume of this cylindrical vessel is say V naught. Whenever the piston is pushed inwards, whenever piston is pushed inwards here, then you see this lever will be, the lever will be closed now. When lever is closed, then whenever the lever is closed and piston is here, the volume of air in the cylindrical tube is equal to say small v. That is called the stroke volume. Stroke volume. That means when you open the valve and if you push the piston inwards, then the lever will be closed so that no air in the tube enter into the vessel or the cylindrical vessel of volume V naught. But whenever the piston is pushed inwards, then it will be closed so that no air enter into the vessel. But this air in the side tube is transferred to the this air in this side tube passing through this tube and they comes out and enter into the a motorcycle tube or water tank. So this volume of one movement of the piston towards left, this volume of the air comes out. That is called the stroke volume. So when for one stroke given to the piston means whenever it is pushed inwards, then we can say one stroke is given. For one stroke, small v volume of the water comes out from the vessel. For one stroke, v small v volume of the air comes out from the vessel. Okay, that is called the stroke volume. Okay, now the temperature of the air remains constant. Temperature P naught, that is constant. Pressure initially, the pressure of the gas is P naught and the volume is V naught. Temperature is maintained constant because surrounding this air is there. Whatever the temperature of the air inside the compressor is also same. That is T naught constant. Okay, now you see here. At first, whenever the piston is here, whenever the piston initially, whenever the piston is closed, then pressure of the air is P naught and volume is V naught. And the piston inwards undi. Initially, the piston inwards undi. Inwards unnapudu idi close ayipoyindi undi kada. At that time, pressure of the air is P naught and volume is V naught. Whenever the piston is moved away like this, then the lever will be opened. When the lever is opened, the air occupies the up to this volume now. The total volume of the air, the volume of this air in the tube is negligible. Only in the side tube. Here, whenever this piston is moved outwards, then the lever will be opened and this air in this compressor enter into the side tube here. The volume of the air in this rubber tube is negligible. Okay, only the volume of this air is small v. That's why when the piston is moved outwards or one stroke is given, then the air occupies up to this volume. So total volume of the air column is equal to V naught plus V now. Initially the piston is inwards, so this lever is closed so that the pressure of the gas is pressure of the air is P naught and volume is V naught. Whenever the at constant temperature, whenever the piston is moved outwards, then lever is opened so that this gas occupies this amount of volume. When the volume increases at constant temperature, pressure decreases now. one stroke ante lever man ikvai piston ikvai move chesam kada one stroke icham anukundam, for one stroke, for one stroke, the first stroke. ప్రెజర్ ఇక్కడ ఎయిర్ ఇక్కడ దాకా ఎక్స్పాండ్ అయినప్పుడు ఇక్కడ దాకా ఎక్స్పాండ్ అప్లై చేసినప్పుడు ప్రెజర్ పి అయింది అనుకుందాం ఫస్ట్ స్ట్రోక్ ప్రెజర్ బికమ్స్ పి1 అండ్ వాల్యూమ్ బికమ్స్ వి ప్లస్ స్మాల్ వి నౌ వి నాట్ ప్లస్ స్మాల్ వి నౌ ఇక్కడ ఈ పిస్టన్ ఇట్ వైపు మూవ్ చేసినప్పుడు అంటే వెనవర్ ద పిస్టన్ ఇస్ గివెన్ వన్ స్ట్రోక్ దెన్ ద వాల్యూమ్ అక్వైర్డ్ బై ద ఎయిర్ ఇన్ ద కంప్రెస్ ఇస్ ఈక్వల్ టు వి నాట్ ప్లస్ వి ఎందుకంటే పిస్టన్ ఇట్ వైపు మూవ్ చేసినప్పుడు లివర్ ఓపెన్ అవుతుంది కాబట్టి ఎయిర్ అక్వైర్స్ అప్ టు దిస్ వాల్యూమ్ సో టోటల్ వాల్యూమ్ ఆఫ్ ఎయిర్ బికమ్స్ వి నాట్ ప్లస్ వి As the volume increases at constant temperature, the pressure decreases. That pressure is say P1. So pressure of the air becomes P1, and first stroke is given. That is equal to initial pressure P0 and initial volume V0 for the same gas. Okay, this is equation one. From this, P1 is equal to P0 into V0 by V0 plus small v. Okay, this is equation one. Small v whole to power one, we can write. The first stroke, the pressure of the air the compressor becomes this one. Now you push the piston towards left and inwards push cheyandi. Actually ee position lo unnapudu piston deentlo unna edeka pressure ee one undi volume v0 plus v undi. Now piston it vai move cheyandi. Move chesinappudu lever close aipothundi. Lever close ainappudu deentlo unna edeka volume v0 e kani pressure p1 dekkinappudu idi close aipoyindi kada deentlo extra air and not ledha kada pressure will not change. So in the second case whenever the piston is moved inwards, then this lever will be closed and the air in this vessel, in this cylindrical side tube, enter into the this tube and comes out. And it fills that cycle tube or motorcycle, car tube, etc. Whatever it may be. Okay, now the piston comes to this position so that the volume of the air in this cylindrical vessel becomes V0 and the pressure is P1. Now, when second stroke is given, for second stroke ichche mundu, అంటే ఈ పిస్టన్ మళ్ళీ ఇటువైపు మూవ్ చేసే ముందు ఇది ఇటువైపు మూవ్ చేస్తాం కాబట్టి మూవ్ చేసినప్పుడు దీంట్లో నా ఏదైక వాల్యూమ్ వి నాట్ ప్రెజర్ పి వన్ ఉంది ఎందుకంటే ఇది ఓపెన్ పిస్టన్ ఇటువైపు మూవ్ చేసినప్పుడు ఇది ఓపెన్ అన్నప్పుడు వాల్యూమ్ వి నాట్ ప్లస్ వి అయింది ఇక్కడ దాకా వస్తుంది కాబట్టి ఎయిర్ ప్రెజర్ ఏమో పి వన్ అయింది ఇప్పుడు దీన్ని ఇటువైపు మూవ్ చేసేటప్పుడు ఇమిడియట్లీ అట్ ఇన్స్టెంట్ వెన్ ఎవర్ ఇట్ స్టార్ట్స్ మూవింగ్ ఇన్వర్స్ ఇమిడియట్లీ ఇట్ విల్ బి క్లోజ్డ్ దట్స్ వై దేర్ ఇస్ నో చేంజ్ ఇన్ ద ప్రెజర్ హియర్ పి వన్ ఏ ఉంటుంది వాల్యూమ్ వి నాట్ ఏ ఉంటుంది ఇక్కడ క్లోజ్ చేసాం కాబట్టి వాల్యూమ్ వి నాట్ ఏ ఉండేది So, if you do next case, low pressure P1, volume V0, it closes some. After that, only outwards open chain and the second stroke, only the divide move chain. Now, put into on the air P1 pressure V0 volume gal air. Only whenever it is given stroke, then the lever will be opened so that the air which is having volume V0 acquires the total volume V0 plus V. So, total volume becomes V0 plus V. But గ్యాస్ ఎక్స్పాండ్ అయిన తర్వాత ప్రెజర్ తగ్గిపోతుంది కదా మళ్ళీ నౌ ఫర్ ద సెకండ్ స్ట్రోక్ ద ప్రెజర్ బికమ్స్ పి2 సో ఫ్రమ్ దిస్ పి2 ఇస్ ఈక్వల్ టు ప్రెజర్ ఆఫ్ ది ఎయిర్ వెన్ ఇట్ అక్వైర్స్ అప్ టు దిస్ వాల్యూమ్ పి2 ఇస్ ఈక్వల్ టు పి1 ఇంటు వి0 బై వి0 ప్లస్ స్మాల్ వి సో దేర్ఫోర్ వాట్ అబౌట్ పి2 పి2 ఇస్ ఈక్వల్ టు పి1 అంటే పి1 మీన్స్ దిస్ వన్ పి1 మీన్స్ పి0 ఇంటు వి0 బై వి0 ప్లస్ స్మాల్ వి Again, V0 by V0 plus V. So, therefore, P2 is equal to P0 into V0 by V0 plus small v whole square. It is equation 2. For first stroke, pressure of the air becomes P0 into V0 by V0 plus V whole to power 1. For second stroke, P0 into V0 by V0 plus V whole square. Therefore, for nth stroke, in this way, n times the piston is pushed back. For nth stroke, the pressure of the air inside the compressor becomes Pn is equal to P0 into V0 by V0 plus small v whole power of n. This is the pressure of the air in the compressor after nth stroke is given. Here V0 is the volume of the compressor. V is small v is the stroke volume. We have to remember these formulas. This formula. Okay. Next. Sixth one. I think only gas expansion of gases may be completed. Okay, next is sixth one. Suppose there are two vessels. There are two vessels. Whatever the shapes, there are two vessels. In which two gases are enclosed at pressure P1, volume V1, and temperature say T. Here pressure P2, volume V2, and temperature under temperature P. Okay, these two vessels are joined by means of a very narrow tube. Very narrow tube. And this tube is closed with wall. The tube is closed with wall. So no exchange of gases from one vessel to another vessel, as both gases are taken at the same temperature. Both gases are taken at the same temperature. Now, when the wall here, the number of moles of the gas initially n1, here say n2. Now, when the gas is here, this valve is opened, and that valve is opened, then of course, in order to discuss this one, we have to discuss the ideal gas equation. Okay, that's why you leave them. Next, we will discuss that one. Next, percentage change in pressure. Okay, we will discuss after completion of ideal gas equation. I will discuss this concept. Okay, next, sixth one. According to Boyle's law, PV is equal to constant, you know, at constant temperature. Okay, now when the volume of the gas, when volume of gas changes by or increases by less than 5%, then percentage change in pressure is what? Percentage change in pressure is what? Equal to dash. Okay, whenever the volume of the gas increases by less than 5%, and volume of the gas increases by 2%, 3%, like that, then what will be the percentage change in pressure? Okay, suppose it is say 4%. Percentage of volume increases by say 2%. 2% means in brackets less than 5%. In such case, we have to do approximate method. We have to use the approximate method. PV is equal to constant means P is proportional to V to power minus 1, we can write now. Then P power 1. So whenever the percentage change is less than 5%, in such case, we have to write the approximate formula. As power is 1 for P, then 1 into delta P by P is equal to minus 1 into delta V by V. Okay. Now you multiply on both sides with 100. Then delta P by P into 100 is equal to minus delta V by V into 100. It is the percentage change in volume, it is the percentage change in pressure. As the volume of the gas increases by 2% at constant temperature, temperature is constant. Because percentage volume of the gas increases by 2%, covered ikkada minus half, percentage increase in volume plus 2 rasukondi. That is equal to minus 2%. So when the volume increases by 2%, then pressure decreases by 2%. Minus sign represents pressure decreases by 2%. Therefore, pressure decreases by 2%. That is the answer. Okay, next. Suppose if the percentage change in volume is more than 5%. If the percentage change in volume is more than 5%. Seventh one, if percentage change in pressure, percentage decrease in pressure, right? Another example, at constant temperature T, when pressure decreases by 10%, comma, then percentage change in volume is dash. At constant temperature, when pressure changes, volume changes. That's why at constant temperature, PV is equal to constant equation is obeyed by the gas. Okay, here P is proposed, PV is equal to constant. As the percentage change in pressure is 10%, percentage change in pressure is 10% means you see, P1V1 is equal to, before changing, pressure is P1, volume is V1. When the pressure changes by 10%, then pressure becomes P2, volume becomes V2. This is equation 1. Pressure decreases by 10% on it. And then final pressure P2 is equal to, initial pressure P1, pressure decreases by 10% and then the final pressure becomes 90 by 100 of original pressure, no? Then that increase by 10% quantity 100 plus 10 by 100 into P1 vastam decrease by 10% kaata 100 minus 10 by 100 ante 90 by 100 into P1. So deen nunchi manaki P1 by P2 value telisinatte ga P1 by P2 is equal to 100 by 90 ante ga, so that is equal to 10 by 9. So P1 by P2 value manaku telusu, therefore ikkada substitute chese from equation 1 P1 by P2 is equal to V2 by V1. That implies P1 by P2 means 10 by 9 is equal to V2 by V1. Percentage change in volume kavali. Percentage change in volume ante final volume minus initial volume whole by initial volume into 100. That is equal to V2 by V1 minus 1 into 100. What is V2 by V1? V2 by V1 is equal to 10 by 9, no? 10 by 9 minus 1 into 100. That is equal to 1 by 9 into 100 ante 100 by 9. 100 by 9 ante 11 point something, no? 9 11s are 99 point, 10 9 ones are. So the positive value, therefore pressure increase by 11.1%. That is the answer. In this way you have to do. If equal to 5 means you have to follow same procedure. Equal to 5 also you follow the same procedure. Okay, right. Next, less than or equal to 5%, that is you follow this procedure. More than 5% means you follow this procedure, then you will get the correct answers. Shall I read this one? Shall I read this part? Next step. Charles law. Charles law. Charles first law. According to Charles first law, at constant pressure, at constant pressure, volume of the gas is directly proportional to Kelvin scale of temperature. Let the absolute scale of temperature. And this the temperature Kelvin scale on undali. Daniki matrame proportional untundi. Centigrade scale on daniki proportional ga undadu. So at constant pressure, the volume of the given mass of gas is directly proportional to its temperature. Okay, or V by T is equal to constant. So in two cases, V1 by T1 is equal to V2 by T2. Okay, at constant temperature, sorry, at constant pressure, when the temperature of the gas is T1, its volume is T2, V1. At constant pressure, if the temperature of the gas is increased to T2, its volume becomes say V2. What is the relation among them? That means V1 by T1 is equal to V2 by T2. V1 by V2 is called T1 by T2, we can write. Okay, similarly, second law, it is also called Charles second law, it is also called as the Gay-Lussac law. Gay-Lussac law. According to Gay-Lussac law, at constant volume P, the pressure of the given mass of gas is directly proportional to Kelvin scale of temperature, or P by T is equal to constant. P by T is called constant. Or T1 by P2 is equal to T1 by T2, we can write. Okay, here this is called isobaric process. Because, sorry, isobaric process. At constant pressure, as the volume changes with temperature, then this process is called isobaric process. Isobaric process. Here, at constant volume, pressure is directly proportional to temperature. It is called, as the volume is constant, it is called isovolumic process, or it is also called as the isochoric process. Isovolumic or isochoric process. Isochoric process. Okay, in this case, T1 by T2 is called T1 by T2, we can write. So whenever necessary, we can write this form, use this formula. Okay, now some note points related to this one. Okay, later we will discuss the note points. Ideal gas equation, I will discuss. ideal gas equation also. Ideal gas equation. IP point of view, it is important. This Charles law, Boyle's law, they are important for IP. Here, all gas laws are obey. All gases obey these gas laws at a high temperature and low pressure. That's why all gases at a high pressure, high temperature, sorry, low pressure and high temperature behaves like ideal gas. The gas which obeys all gas laws at any temperature and pressure, that is called the ideal gas. But in case of all other gases, in case of real gases at low pressure and high temperature, they obey the all gas laws. That's why the real gases act behaves like ideal gas at low pressure and high temperature. Okay, ideal gas. Suppose here, initially, the pressure of the gas is taken P1, volume is V1, and temperature is T1. Pressure of the gas is taken in a vessel at a temperature T1, pressure is P1, and volume is V1. Now, by Boyle's law, that means by keeping temperature constant, by Boyle's law, T1 only, the volume of the gas is changed to V. At constant temperature, when volume changes, then pressure also changes, no? Now pressure becomes P2. Next, the same gas, by keeping the pressure constant, means Charles' first law. By keeping pressure constant, when temperature of the gas is increased to T2, volume becomes, say, V2. Now, in this case, how we can write as the Boyle's law? Here the process change. Here this Boyle's law is also called as the isothermal process because temperature is constant. At constant temperature, when pressure and volume of the gas changes take place, such a process is called isothermal process. Here as the which one is constant? Pressure is constant. It is called isobaric process. In isobaric process, the temperature changes from T1 to T2, volume changes from V2 to V2. Isobaric process. Now, these two states of the same gas, we apply the Boyle's law. According to Boyle's law, at constant temperature, T1 V1 is equal to V2 into V. This is equation one. Here, in case of isobaric process, you apply the Charles' first law. According to the Charles' first law, at constant pressure, at constant pressure, V by T is equal to constant, and V by T1 is equal to V2 by T2. That implies from this formula, V is equal to, we can write V2 T1 by T2, we can write now, this is equation 2. Substitute this 2, from equation 2, we substitute the value of V in equation 1, 2 in 1, T1 V1 is equal to P2 into, V means V2 T1 by T2. That implies we can write P1 V1 by T1 is equal to P2 V2 by T2. So in another state, suppose the pressure is P3, volume is V3, temperature is T3. Then we can write P3 V3 by T3. That means this is equal to constant. In general, in any state of the gas, if pressure is P and volume is V and temperature is T, then according to this relation, we can write in general, PV by T is equal to constant. Or the constant is equal to, for one mole of gas, this constant is equal to capital R. The constant is equal to capital R, called universal gas constant. The constant is called universal gas constant. The ideal gas equation derivation not important and because SI question ga adagachu IP lo. So here from this formula for one mole of gas, PV by T is equal to constant is equal to capital R property. PV is equal to RT, we can write R into T, where R universal gravitational, sorry, universal gas constant. Universal gas constant. Or it is also called as the ideal gas constant. Ideal gas constant. For n moles of gas, 1 mole kaithe Kaplan and for n moles of gas, PV is equal to nR into T. This is the ideal gas equation. This is called ideal gas equation. Ideal gas. Okay. From this formula, number of moles, n is equal to mass by, we can write molecular weight, capital M, or number of molecules by Avogadro number, we can write. Number of molecules by Avogadro number. What is the Avogadro number? Tell me. What is the Avogadro number? 6.023 into 10^23 per mole, kada? Okay. So instead of N, you write this one. PV is equal to nRT. From that, N means mass by molecular weight into capital R into T. So PV is equal to small m into capital R by capital M is the small r into T. Where small r is equal to capital R by capital M. This small r is called real gas constant or simply gas constant. Real gas constant. Real gas constant. Expansion of gases work to complete the exam only. Repo Keller matrix so far. Okay. So here small r is called real gas constant. Real gas constant is called capital R by capital M. Capital R, it does not depend on the any gas, does not depend on the nature of the gas. For any gas, universal gas constant is constant. That's why it does not depend on the nature of the gas. But real gas constant depends on the nature of the gas. Real gas constant is equal to capital R by capital M. Of course, capital R is constant for all gases. For different gases, molecular weights are different. No? That's why real gas constant is different for different gases. Real gas constant depends on the nature of the gas. It depends on nature of gas. Depends on mix of the gas. Next, PV is equal to, instead of number of moles, you write N by NA. Number of molecules by Avogadro number. Number of molecules by Avogadro number. Avogadro's number. Okay. You write instead of small n in this formula, you write N by NA. Okay. Into RT. Therefore, PV is equal to capital N into R by NA, you write, into capital T. So, PV is equal to N into, what about R by NA? Universal gas constant by, yeah, Avogadro number is 6.023 into 10^23. Okay. N into R by NA means that is capital K. K suffix B or capital K into T. Where capital K is called Boltzmann constant. Capital K is called Boltzmann constant. Boltzmann's constant. Here, the universal gas constant value. Universal gas constant unit is joule per mole per Kelvin. The unit of universal gas constant is joule per mole per Kelvin. Okay, its value in SI system is universal gas constant value is equal to 8.314. Joule per mole per Kelvin. That is also equal to 2 calorie per mole per Kelvin. Because 1 calorie is equal to approximately 4.2 joule. 1 calorie is equal to approximately 4.2 joule. Nearly equal to 4.2 joule. That's why 2 calorie is 2 into 4.2, approximately 8.4. So approximate value that is. Okay. Next, this is also equal to Okay, this is the universal gas constant, Boltzmann constant, K. Boltzmann constant is equal to 1.38 into 10^23 joule per mole per Kelvin. Boltzmann constant is equal to 1.38 into 10^-23, sorry, -23 joule per mole per Kelvin. 1.38 into 10^-23 joule per mole per Kelvin. Okay. Now, just 3-4 note points. I will conclude the class. Previously, I stopped one diagram graph. Now, I will explain now. Okay, note points. One. Suppose we are having PV graph for the same gas at two different constant temperatures. By keeping the temperature T1 constant, PV graph is drawn like this. By keeping the temperature of the gas constant at the T2 temperature, again I drawn the PV graph, I got like this. Then, what about the relation between these two? T1, T2 relation only. We know for any gas PV is equal to nRT. PV is equal to nRT. nR is constant. So PV is directly proportional to T. Okay. Now, from this point, you draw a horizontal line. Then at this point, pressure is same now. So at this point, pressure is same. So exactly at this point, volume is. As the temperature here is T1, volume is say V1. As the temperature here is T2, volume is say V2. Okay, now at constant pressure, in case of the gases at two different temperatures, we maintain the pressure constant here and here. So at constant pressure, volume is directly proportional to temperature. Now, as the volume V2 is greater, at this point, the temperature is greater. That's why as V2 greater than V1, then at a volume V2, as the temperature is T2, T2 greater than T1. In this way, we can check. Okay. Or by keeping the volume constant, the pressure is directly proportional to temperature. As the pressure P2 here is more, P2 greater than P1. That's why P2 greater than T1. So we can write like this. Next. This is one. Next here. Suppose in two vessels, the two gases are taken. P at pressure P1, volume V1, and temperature T. And here pressure P2, volume V2, temperature T. Here, both are. These two vessels are joined by means of a narrow tube. These two are joined by means of a narrow glass tube provided with valve. When valve is closed, then no exchange of gases from one vessel to another vessel. Initially, the number of moles of the gas in this vessel is say N1. Here it is say N2. Okay, now whenever the valve is opened, these two are chemically non-reactive gases. Kabatti number of moles maru. Chemically non-reactive. So whenever the valve is opened, the gas rushes from one vessel to another vessel or exchanged between these two vessels until it reaches a common pressure. A common pressure P ankonde. Common pressure P. Common pressure P ankonde. Temperature T ne. Constant temperature dekar ankonde. Temperature constant ade maru. Okay. If the gas exchange jarigindi kabatti, now the number of moles becomes N1 dash and number of moles in this vessel becomes N2 dash say. Initially, whenever the valve is closed, the number of moles of the gas in the two vessels is equal to N1 plus N2. Whenever the valve is opened, the number of moles of this gas is N1 dash and in this is N2 dash. So, total number of moles is equal to this one. As no leakage of the gas to the surroundings, okay, and a bite different gas leaked out your property, total number of moles remains constant before opened, even after opened, okay. I say, on this ideal gas equation, PV is equal to nRT, R constant. N is proportional to PV by T. Raskocha. Now we substitute here. N1 means PV by T. N1 means P1 V1 by T. P1 V1 by T. Of course, here, P is a constant. So N is proportional to PV. Directly we can write. కూడా కాన్స్టెంట్ అన్ని కేసు రెండు కేసెస్ లో. సో ఎన్ వన్ అంటే డైరెక్ట్ గా పీవీ, ఇక్కడ పీవీ అంటే పి వన్ వి వన్ ప్లస్ ఎన్ టూ అంటే ఇక్కడ బిఫోర్ వాల్వ్ ఇస్ ఓపెన్ రిజల్ట్ పీ టూ వాల్వ్ ఇన్ వి టూ, దట్స్ వై పీ టూ ఇన్ వి టూ ఇస్ ఈక్వల్ టు ఎన్ వన్ డాష్ అంటే ఆఫ్టర్ వాల్వ్ ఇస్ ఓపెన్ ద ప్రెజర్ బికమ్స్ పి, హియర్ ప్రెజర్ బికమ్స్ పి. ఇక్కడ రెండింటి వాల్వ్ ఓపెన్ చేశారు కాబట్టి దీంట్లో గ్యాస్ దీంట్లో కంటే ఎక్స్చేంజ్ అయ్యి ఎక్స్చేంజ్ ఆఫ్ గ్యాస్ టేక్స్ ప్లేస్ అంటిల్ ద ప్రెజర్స్ ఆర్ ఈక్వల్. కాబట్టి కామన్ ప్రెజర్ పి ఇంటూ వాల్యూమ్ బి వన్, ఇక్కడ కామన్ ప్రెజర్ పి ఇంటూ వాల్యూమ్, వాల్యూమ్ ఏం మారదుగా. సో ఫ్రమ్ దిస్ కామ్ యూ టేక్ పి కామన్, పి ఆఫ్ వి వన్ ప్లస్ వి టూ, ఇట్ ఇస్ పి వన్ వి వన్ ప్లస్ పి టూ వి టూ. దేర్ఫోర్ కామన్ ప్రెజర్ పి ఈజ్ ఈక్వల్ టు పి వన్ వి వన్ ప్లస్ పి టూ వి టూ హోల్ బై వి వన్ ప్లస్ వి టూ, విచ్ ఇస్ ద కామన్ ప్రెజర్. It is the common pressure. In this way, we can do. Okay, next. At same temperature for two different gases. Sorry, at same temperature T. A gas is taken having different masses m1 and m2 at a constant temperature for the given gas having mass m1, pv graph is drawn. For the same gas having mass m2, by keeping the same temperature T constant, again pv graph is drawn. Then the graphs are obtained like this. What about the relation between m1 and m2? Pv is equal to nRT. Pv is equal to n means mass by molecular weight into r into T. Okay, for the given gas, both in both the cases gas are same, that's why R, M are same. Temperature is also same. Okay, so PV is directly proportional to mass. Now, you draw a Hardenk line so that both graphs intersect. So exactly at this point, volume is say it is the first gas, the mass is M1, so volume is say V1. It is the second gas having mass M2, here volume is say V2. At this point and at this point, pressures are same. That's why pressure is also maintained constant. That implies V is proportional to M. Here the volume is more, mass is more in that case. ఇక్కడ V1 తో కంపేర్ చేస్తే V2 greater కదా ఈ యాక్సిస్ మీద, V2 greater అంటే ఇక్కడ mass M2 greater. Okay, that's why M2 as V2 greater than V1, that implies M2 greater than M1. In this way we can find the mass of the gas relation. Fourth one. Suppose P or V and small v and centigrade scale temperature. Graph draw this example. Suppose if you draw the graph with the Kelvin scale of temperature on x-axis and P or V along y-axis, you will get a straight line because V is proportional to T now. That's why you get a straight line passing through origin. But if you draw the graph between pressure and temperature in centigrade scale, then you will get the graph like this. It is having, when you extend this graph, it is having intersection on temperature axis, and at this point the temperature is minus 273 degrees centigrade approximately. How many degree Kelvin? Plus 273 means 0 Kelvin. 273 degrees centigrade or 0 Kelvin. At 0 Kelvin temperature, the volume of the given gas is 0 and the pressure is also 0. Next one. For the same, suppose if you draw the Kelvin scale of temperature versus pressure graph or volume graph, you will get a straight line passing through RC. It is 0 Kelvin. Okay. Suppose by keeping pressure P1 constant, by keeping pressure P1 constant, when VT graph is drawn, the graph is obtained like this. By keeping pressure of the given gas constant at P2, when volume and temperature graph is drawn, then the graph is obtained like this. Then what is the relation between these two? P1, P2 relation. Okay, here also, just from any point here, you draw a horizontal line so that it intersects the two graphs at this point. So exactly at this point, temperature is T1, say, sorry, here pressure is P1. So temperature is T1. At this point, as the pressure is P2, P2 constant, occurrence, at the pressure P2, temperature is say T2. So from PV is equal to nRT. Okay, nR constant and pressure line with the volume constant, pressure is directly proportional to temperature. From this graph, as temperature T2 is greater, as T2 greater than T1, from this graph, then T is proportional to T, kavati T2 greater than T1 ayinappudu pressure P2 greater than P1 avutundi. So P2 is greater. Okay. Similarly, in case of pressure temperature graph at constant volumes, we can draw like this. Okay. So these are the cases, different cases. Okay. Now, based on this, already in case of expansion of liquids, I send the problems to be done. All problems, you do those problems. Okay. Bye. Have a nice day. I'm signing out. All of you, good night. Today, tomorrow, I will be available for you. Okay. Bye, Nana. Good night, all of you. Okay. In 15 minutes, if possible, you do how many problems, whatever the number of problems you can do, you do. Okay. You cannot do more problems. So, whatever the number of problems you can do, you do. Right, Nana. Tomorrow, I will be available. Today, I don't want to be available because I have to take rest. Okay. Bye, all of you. Good night, and all of you. Take care.